Now here we are in Chrome, Google Chrome, and in the URL bar there, the address bar, I'll just start typing StatPlus, and what we're looking for is the Mac space LE. So that's the Mac version, Lite Edition. That's the one that's free of charge that we don't have to pay for. So if, as I said, enter, it'll search, and lo and behold, analystsoft.com makes StatPlus. I'm going to go straight for the downloads page. That'll open in a while, and there's the download button, which I'll do. If you then go to your downloads folder or wherever you've set the downloads to occur, and you double click on that, will open an install package. Just follow the instructions. It usually just asks you to drag it across to your application folder. So let's close this, and there's our applications folder, and here we have StatPlus. If I double click on StatPlus, StatPlus will open, and in the background also open a Microsoft Excel workbook. Now, if I've recently worked on a file, I might go search for it down here, or we can just open a blank file. There we go. There's a blank file. You can also have worked on a spreadsheet like this with all your data and then double click on StatPlus. Now on the mouse that I'm using, I can double click hold both sides of the mouse in, the two buttons on the side. I can switch between applications, there's StatPlus. And there under statistics, I see all the statistical analysis I can do. Basically gives me the same types of statistics I can do as with the Windows version. You'll note some of them are only available when you buy the software pro here. So usually we can just do normal descriptive statistics and then the comparison of means, comparing means and various other tests. So you have to install the software to give you the same sort of functionality as you get with a Windows version. Once I've worked on the spreadsheet, I can then do the statistical analysis and the results will appear in my spreadsheet here. So that's the installation of StatPlus. Please go and do that so that you can follow along with the rest of the lecture series, at least as far as the Mac version of Microsoft Excel is concerned.